Hi, this is Pat Love with Pat's Two Cents. Question: how many of you have felt like you have gone through from pain to pain, from sorrow to sorrow, and it seems like your wounds have wounds, your scars have cuts and sores in them, and it seems like it's so difficult to heal from all the mess that was done to you when you were young? All through the years, you go from sorrow to abuse, from abuse to someone taking advantage of you, from someone taking advantage of you to disrespect, from disrespect to contempt, from contempt back to abuse. It almost seems like a vicious cycle. Well, that's not the abundant life. God did not intend that for us. That is a personal attack from Satan to make us miss the mark, to make us fall back into sin through bitterness, anger, resentment, the whole nine yards. God has so much more. I lived in that pit hole for years, but I want to let you know, the way God pulled me up and out, He can do the same with you. You don't have to live with that pain you have right now. Some people say when a person dies, you never get over the pain. Yes, you do, because God heals. Some people say the stuff that you live with all your life, all that anguish from your childhood, you never get over it. Listen, God is able. He did it for me. And I want to build up your hope to know you are not stuck in that pit for the rest of your life. Do you hear me? All right, now I'm going to read Isaiah chapter 61, verses 1 through 4. And I'm going to elaborate. I'm going to play a little song. I'm not singing it. I'm going to play it, just a piece of it. And I'm going to come back with Pat's Two Cents to let you know just how well able, how willing, how hungry God is for our healing, for our deliverance, for our freedom, total restoration. Listen, and I'm going to read right now. The Spirit of the Lord God is upon me, because the Lord has anointed me to preach good tidings unto the meek. He has sent me to bind up the brokenhearted, to proclaim liberty to the captives, and the opening of the prison to them that are bound, to proclaim the acceptable year of the Lord and the day of vengeance of our God, to comfort all that mourn, to appoint unto them that mourn in Zion, to give unto them beauty for ashes, the oil of joy for mourning, the garment of praise for the spirit of heaviness, that they might be called trees of righteousness, the planting of the Lord, that he might be glorified. And they shall build the old wastes, they shall raise up the former desolations, and they shall repair the waste cities, the desolations of many generations. Now, a lot of times, Pat's Two Cents, a lot of times we see a generational cycle, of abuse, of molestation, of rape, of suicide, of sickness. I mean, it just can get really crazy, and we wonder, why was this put on me? Well, listen, the whys aren't important as to the how. Because the how tells you how God can get you out of something that was supposed to be, according to the demonic assignment on your life, supposed to be your lot in life. But God has another plan. Now, I want you to hear this let me make sure I have the name right. Don't go anywhere. Byron Cage. You hear this song and let it bless you. I'm going to play a snippet of it, and I'm going to come back with Pat's Two Cents, because I want you to know there is totally a way out for you. You're wondering how, aren't you? Listen.
So you enter into this building.
You enter into this building.
You brought your burdens.
You brought your burdens.
Brought your pain.
And your pain.
But I have a message for you today, that when you leave here, won't be the same.
You don't have to remain the same. You really don't. You're not locked in.
So you tell me, you've been to your position. In your condition, reach out and touch the master's robe. Yes, healing for your mind.
Healing for your mind.
Oh, your body and your soul.
Your body, your heart, and your soul. God can heal you, I'm telling you. He delivered me from a root of rejection. He can mend your broken heart. He works miracles. He loves healing hearts. You will receive like I did. I received so much healing. All my insecurities are out the window.
About the situation.
He knows about it.
But with every test and every trial, there is revelation.
If you open your eyes and hear.
More than able.
He can supply all of your needs. He set me free, you guys. He set me free. And he can do it for you. He can deliver. You don't have to stay there. Miracles. Thank you, Lord, for doing it for me. Trust him. You will receive. Will receive. Trust me when I say that. See, a lot of times what we don't get, we don't realize that things that have haunted us, that have plagued us, that have crippled us, hindered us, sabotaged us, God can totally do away with. The pain that you feel on a daily basis, the torment that makes you pick up that liquor bottle and drink, the one that makes you want to smoke weed to kill the pain, to numb it, that makes you want to get high off of drugs, off of sex, off of pornography, all off of attention, whatever your high is. When God gets done with you, all those needs are met. I needed affection. I needed approval. I need to believe that my mother loved me. I needed to believe I was worth something, that I was worth even being here. And God revealed his supernatural love to me. You hear me? And for the first time, I was able to love myself. Do you love yourself? Or do you just tolerate yourself because you think you're a lost cause? You're not. Not with God on our side. God can do exceedingly abundantly above all you could ask or even think, according to the power that works in you. What power are you willing to allow to work in you? All you need power to do is ask. Just believe a little bit. But ask. And you will receive. Don't just ask once. You ask over and over and over and over. You hear me? And you'll be saying, like he's singing, I have received. Listen. Go to God right now and say, Lord, I'm talking about those of you who are already saved. Begin the healing process. I need help. My anger is out of control. I am tired of depression weighing me down. I'm tired of this heaviness of the monkey I've been carrying on my back. Go to him. He doesn't even charge. Now listen, for those of you who are not saved, accept Jesus in your heart. Ask God for mercy, forgiveness, to give you a whole new start. And then ask him for his Holy Spirit to change your nature so that it's easy for you to make the transition. That's what the Holy Spirit does, one of the things. And then ask him to heal your heart and uproot all the toxins and the poisons that has been destroying you all these years, that has set you on a course of self-destruct for decades, that has caused some of you to cut yourself and others to try to commit suicide, and some of you to sabotage relationships and sabotage your jobs. And oh my goodness, God can change it, you guys. He can change it. I know what I'm talking about. It's not no fairy tale. This is a fact. When I wasn't even sure if I believed in God. Do you hear me? Ask him in there. In the name of Jesus, I pray, God, heal your soul. Be encouraged. Your change will come.